I need to do something. And from this gentleman, Dr. Li Kaifu, former Google executive and AI expert. He classified our types of jobs in five categories. And I'm very happy to know that creative type of job is the safest. Okay, why? Because those repetitive jobs, routine jobs, all will be automated by AI very, very soon. So creative type of job will be safe. And what does that mean? Creativity is about ideas. I know some of you are working in companies, some of you are running your own company, and sometimes you are handling some routine repetitive tasks. If that's the case, you need to move up the value chain really fast because your government needs to automate and delegate those repetitive tasks. Now, how can you tell you are creative? Or how can you tell your colleague or your boss is creative? You can actually follow this framework I developed according to the ideas pyramid. There are four levels. The first level is what I call stuck. Stuck means what? Stuck means stuck. That means you can't think of anything else except being stuck. What does that mean? That means when your boss or when your client asks you, hey, what do you think? Do you have any ideas? Then your eyes start to look onto the floor. That's how you know you are in the state of stuck. And the next level is what I call open. Open means somehow visible, somehow invisible. Like you have some idea but you're not too sure. You don't know how to share. You have something but you're not sure. So that is what I call open. And the third level is what I call flow. Flow means you have a lot of ideas coming in. You know you're in a state of flow and you have a lot of ideas. But somehow you don't know which one to prioritize or you don't know which one to try. That is flow. And last one is what I call thrive. Thrive means you are implementing some ideas and you're making progress with your ideas, you're probably making money with your ideas. This is what I call thrive. So this applies not just to you as an entrepreneur, but it can also apply to you as an employee. So for example, if you take ideas in-house and then you roll it out once you get approval from the upper management, you launch it, you are reaching the level of thrive. If you are an entrepreneur, if you have turned an idea into a reality, you are making progress, making money, you are also in the state of thrive. Then the key question is, how can you move up from the stuck to thrive? How do you move up the idea pyramid? That's why I developed a framework called the idea pyramid. I think we need to think. Yes. So where are you right now? So the question is, where are you right now? And also, where is your team? So if you are stuck, your team is already high up there, that means you're in trouble. On the other hand, if you are high up there, your team is at the bottom, you are also in trouble because you need to pull the team up. So either case, you have to know how to move up. So how to move this up? Let me share with you a simple three-step analogy. Okay, this is what I call the three-eye model. Ideas, individual mindset, as well as infrastructure. So if you want to be creative, you just need to focus on these three things. So first thing first, individual mindset. That is, you have to develop a creative individual mindset. Question for you. Let's say you need to develop a marketing campaign to reach 100,000 people. We're still better. Sounds familiar. Your boss always told you, hey, you're able to do so and so. Oh, no better. Is it possible? Can or cannot? Some of you say can. Some of you are not so convincing. Actually, the target is we want to reach 280,000 people. We're still better. Is it possible? volunteer. They dress up these two volunteers as handlers. And somehow there's a shopping mall nearby, and there's a big escalator connecting the upper floor and the ground floor. So let's imagine this. There's a big shopping mall, this escalator keeps going up and down, going up and down, and they point these two handlers in this shopping mall. One handler downstairs. The other handler upstairs. So what happened is the panda upstairs, they took out the poster. It is something like an A4 size poster. They have no budget, but they can still afford to keep one poster on one A4 paper. So they peel it out. Then the panda upstairs hand out to the mall visitor who is traveling down the escalator. So this mall visitor is traveling down the escalator. Down, 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 down. So reach the ground floor, and the other handler took it back. Give it to the other person who is traveling up the escalator. Up, okay, finish. Then the other handler took it back. Give it to the other person who is traveling down, 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 rip, 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 and then took it back. Another person. So up, down, up, down, up, down for a couple hours. People start to wonder what's going on. People start to take photo, take video, and then video was sent to journalists, social media, and it generated 280,000 of reach online and offline. We're still better, except for 1 year and 1 year. So what's the learning point here? Be the panda, is it? The learning point here is stop saying cannot, start saying why not. Stop saying cannot, start saying why not. It's a small shift, but can be big implication. So stop saying cannot, start to say
why not.
Why not? Thank you. And actually, if you can convince your boss to say why not, you will get whatever you want. Think about it, if you can convince your boss to say why not, you can get whatever you want. So that means you have to educate your boss on creativity. And if you can get your boss to say why not, you can get whatever you want. The second thing that you can do to increase your creativity is what I call infrastructure. Infrastructure means you have to be different, be creative in the way you do things. Infrastructure, right? The way you do things. Let's imagine this. Let's imagine you are an HR manager. Right? I know some of you are not HR manager, but let's assume you're a manager in the HR area and you need to recruit skilled car mechanics. What will you do? What will you do? Post it on job posts, right? Go to monster.com, jobstv.com, whatever, right? Okay, that's fine, you can do that. But if you advertise online, it's a problem. People might not be it. Not 100% of people will read it. Now, this company in Germany, what they have done was something creative. They asked the HR manager to go and get some second-hand car, and we have a damaged engine, hopefully. So they gather all the second-hand car with a faulty engine, and then they ask the HR manager to print out the job ad, and then fold it, and roll it, and then stuff it inside those packing engine. And then after that, send all this damaged car to those car repair workshops across Germany. So we just send all this damaged car to all the car repair workshops in Germany. As a result, 100% reach. This campaign maximized recruitment ROI because you can't just, if you're a car mechanic, you open up this car engine, the job ad will just drop right in front of your face. So this is a creative recruitment campaign. And doing things differently. And that's the second learning point is stop thinking about the content. Start thinking about the context. So it's not about the stuff that you're working on that matters, but it's about the context. Okay. So for example, if you are in a recruitment, don't focus about the job ad. It's focused on the audience feed or the candidate feed. So look at the bigger picture. So if you are in the automobile industry, you are not selling cars, but you are selling mobility and freedom. And let's say if you are in the technology space, if you are in the cloud computing, open source technology. Your focus should not be on the technology itself. You should focus on If you want to be creative, you need to know how to generate ideas. How to generate ideas. One of the simple methods is what I call the combination method. A plus B gives you C. 7 years ago in London, there was a homeless guy. And as you know, London, the winter can be quite cold. Okay, so it's a freezing cold. And this guy has no food, no money. So he begged me some food, begged me some money. So he started to make a direct request. Can you give me some money? I'm very cold. Can you give me some food? I'm very hungry. Can you give me some money? The response he got is exactly like what I'm getting right now. Nobody cares about me. Damn. This homeless guy decided that, how about I do some creativity thing? Then he started to think about, why do I combine a game? Why do I combine a game with a direct request? And not just a direct request, but a game. And then he started to go to the rubbish bin, take out some empty container. He goes to the rubbish bin, take out some empty container. So he collects about 10 empty containers laid in front of him. And he started to write one sentence. And this one sentence changed his life. The sentence is, which religion care the most about the homeless? Then people start to donate, okay? I'm a Catholic, I'm going to donate more. I'm a Buddhist, I'm going to donate more. I'm a Muslim, I'm going to donate more. So all these boxes are full. All because of one crazy idea. Combining A and B. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if this guy in UK can do it, I believe we can all do it. So if you can do it, we all can do it. You just need to exercise your creative brain somehow. Let's see. Okay. What if you combine a printer with a workshop? What will you have? Printer and a workshop. It is a global printer. It's a construction equipment. And then you just pay the payment, you just print the payment out. And what if you combine, okay, combine events with human interaction? Okay, I hope to see most of you in my head. Okay? And I hope there will be something interesting happening in my head. I'm sure it will, but let me share with you one more idea. What if you combine a conference with some human interaction? What will you have? You will have something called a networking corner in a conference. Networking corner in a conference. That is, idea is actually, I have a friend, Gil Prinsfield. Okay? He is the mastermind behind this idea. So he worked with the conference organizer to set up a connecting wall, a networking corner. So the conference attendees, okay, in addition to listening to the conference presentation, they can actually network, and you can also stuff your name card on the wall. And let's say if you're a buyer looking for seller, if you're a seller looking for buyer, or if you're a teacher looking for student, if you're a student looking for teacher, you all can benefit from him. So that's the third one is my idea. So to recap. We have this like idea generation using the combination method. Stop thinking about content, focus on the context, and then think about why not, and stop saying that. Now, to put things into perspective, let me share with you a simple case study from KLM, the Dutch airline. KLM is a Dutch airline based out in the Netherlands. They have a big problem. The big problem is German people never heard of KLM. 46% don't know what is KLM. You think about it, it is quite scary. It is like we live in Singapore, but 46% of Malaysians never heard of Singapore Airlines. Is that a big trouble for you? Big, big trouble. Now, to make the situation worse, German people think KLM is actually a bank. Is that a bank? Is that a restaurant? Or is it a radio station? They thought KLM is a bank, a radio station, or a restaurant. If you are the KLM management, you are in deep trouble.
half of the German people never heard of you and they think of you wrongly. But what they have done was something crazy. Actually, they said, why not we set up KLM as a KLM bank? So they actually set up KLM ATM machine for a period of time. And you insert your normal bank card, they won't give you cash, but they will give you a free ticket. You can fly KLM for free. And they also set up a radio station. They have a KLM song. And they even set up a KLM restaurant. Now, they give you free meals inside this restaurant. And the meal is the in-flight meal, KLM in-flight meal. So, what does that mean here? That means if you can start to say why not, and so for KLM management, they say why don't we become a bank, why don't we become a restaurant? And then they also think about not just about the content, it's not about marketing of the airline, but it's about the context, and what the target customers is thinking of us. And of course, KLM doing a lot of idea generation with their advertising agency, TV. So this is how you can put the 3I in perspective. Now, whatever I share with you this evening is only a small part of a bigger picture. In fact, there are actually 9 different ways where you can develop your creativity in preparation towards the future. And I have prepared some small gift for you, and so you can get it if you like. So, a couple things. I have a YouTube channel, so if you like, you can check out some content that will be useful for you and also useful for your team and use, and sometimes even useful for your boss, so you can take a look if you like. And then secondly, I also have my book available at the back, so today starting at $20. And then I also prepare some small gift for you, so you can download it immediately if you like. So what you need to do is you get your QR scan already, that's what I'm going to show you the QR code. So you select what you want, click confirm, and then check your email. So this is the QR code. So perhaps I stop here for 1 or 2 minutes and let you enter some information, and then after that I will do the closing remark. So give you 1.5 minutes. I'll stop here for 1.5 minutes. Okay, so to move on, what's my final message? mindset infrastructure and ideas as a starting point. So with that, shall I stop my presentation right here? Shall I? Why not? Yeah, why not I stop here? Okay. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. Okay. So I think we can take two quick questions.
Yeah, okay. Any questions for Vincent?
Do you have any quick questions? Two questions? Any questions? Can you try? Why not ask a question?
I was hoping somebody asked for another class. But I always have questions. So I'm thankful for Dickson for the call, Kai. And I think I did a lot. I just wanted to revisit your ideas framework between 3 and 4. The part that's the flow and 5. The typical situation is that from a startup with many ideas, getting many ideas is not a problem. This is what you shared, fully using the infrastructure tactic, the context and all that. Is it possible through your quick answer to share a tip? And how do you move from flow to thrive, sitting out all these ideas, putting them in context, and then maybe focusing on 1 or 2 power ideas to move forward?
Sure.
We have not tried yet.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. What's your name?
My name is Derek.
Derek, great question. So you, first of all, I must congratulate you because you're already at level 3, moving to level 4. Okay, so that is your great advantage in this day. Typically, when we mentioned the state of flow, flow means you have a lot of ideas, but somehow, your biggest trouble is you don't know how to organize all these ideas and make sense of ideas and select those ideas who are so-called worth to explore. So if you find that you or your team is at this flow, many ideas, what you need to do is you need to categorize them. You need to know how to categorize them. So what are some of the tips that you can use to categorize them? Now, different people might have different methodology, but I'm not sure exactly what your team members' background, but the most easier way to categorize your ideas is to use something what I call the SML. SML, short term, medium term, and long term. So if they have some ideas, they can be implemented immediately. Now, how do you define immediately? I think it will be up to your core, depending on your company vision. So some of you may say, okay, within 3 months, I will put it as the S category, right? Short term. Then 3 to 12 months is the medium term. And anything beyond that, it will be in the long term. So this is one way that you can organize the activity, the ideas and activity. So that's the flow. And then after that, right, what do you mean by how to go from the flow to thrive? Right? So in order for you to thrive, okay, there are a couple of things you can consider. Number one is the revenue potential. So can you monetize that idea? So this is one thing, is like, can you monetize it? Number two is that idea that you chosen, right, is it in line with the trend? Is it in line with the future trend? So the future trend could be, a lot of apps now is using voice to activate. So are you riding on this like voice technology trend? Let's say car computing, are you also riding on that trend? Right? So to answer your question, at the 5 level, right, you need to look at your monetization opportunity and also are you riding on the trend? So typically, when you ride on a trend, right, you will find more easily. Okay, so I hope this helped. Okay, thank you. One last question? Yeah, why not?
I got a question that's a little bit related with, but a little different. That as a leader, I usually bump into some problem is that my members, when I ask my members the ideas, they usually don't speak out. And either, like you say, that they don't know the answer, the idea is correct or co-work with the future planning with it, or actually it is will be accepted or not. So I probably didn't have it with the Western culture part, but it's more with the like Chinese culture things. So my question will be that for the stage from to bring out, and how do we our members and how do we to like brainstorming the last kind of thing. During the college part I joined with, we usually just bring out nonsense ideas and try to write out the character that you say and to finally bring the new idea with.
Mm. Sure. So, thank you. That's a great question. So, let me rephrase your question, right, to make sure that I understand correctly. So you're saying that how you can actually get people to share ideas more openly, right? Maybe for some of the Asians, they are a little bit shy to share ideas. So how to get them to share ideas, right? Okay, two things here. Number one is, I can totally echo your point that sometimes Asians are a bit shy, right, to share ideas. So what you can do is, you can actually use a small piece of paper, right? Sometimes you just use a post-it or just a small paper. Ask them to write. Instead of asking them to verbally share, ask them to write. So that is one way you can do it, right? Because they feel more comfortable writing. When you get them to write, they will write a lot. They will write 26 ideas. But when you ask them, hey, do you have any idea? Then they back to start, no idea. So one way you can do it is ask them to write. And secondly is, what you can do is you can pair them up. Like group two people together or group three people together, and typically in a pair environment or group environment, they feel more easy and natural to share ideas. But if you can ask them to share ideas individually, they feel a bit scared. And so you can group them up. So group them up, or you can get them to write. Thank you. Okay, so with that, I want to pass the time to Jim. Thank you so much for having me.